And while Prime Minister Modi has set political circles abuzz with a dig at the opposition INDI bloc, speaking about the differences within the INDI, the Prime Minister said that the battle over the prime ministerial face has reached a crescendo in the INDI bloc. While he didn't name any leader, the Prime Minister said that over the last 15 days, there's a storm brewing within the opposition as one of the top leaders from the alliance has refused to campaign till they are declared the prime ministerial face.
पर कभी मामला क्या है, ठंडे पड़े हो। वैसे उनके एक नेता ने बयान भी कर दिया कि हमारे लोग बहुत सुस्त है, ठंडे है, कुछ करना नहीं चाहते। तो उन्होंने कहा कि इंडी गठबंधन की वरिष्ठ नेतागिरी में पिछले 15 दिन से बहुत तूफान चल रहा है। इंडी गठबंधन उन्हें प्रधानमंत्री का उम्मीदवार घोषित नहीं करेगा, वो एक भी चुनाव प्रचार में नहीं जाएंगे। अब ये हाल है उनका, वो बता नहीं पा रहे हैं उनका नेता कौन है, और वो अंदर अंदर लड़ रहे हैं। और इंडी गठबंधन वाले कहते हैं कि भाई अभी नहीं, चुनाव नतीजे आने के बाद तय करेंगे। अब वो अड़ करके बैठ गए हैं और वो कहते हैं जब तक मुझे नेता घोषित नहीं करोगे मैं कोई रैली करने वाला नहीं हूं।
While the Prime Minister didn't name any leader, speculations are rife over who the leader could be. Remember, the INDI bloc has not declared any prime ministerial candidate. The opposition leaders have decided that the decision will be taken only after they come to power. The BJP has been mocking the opposition stand, saying the INDI bloc is just an anti-Modi bloc where each leader wants to be the prime minister, including Rahul Gandhi, Mallikarjun Kharge, Mamata Banerjee, Arvind Kejriwal and Sharad Pawar.
बड़ी पीटी पिटाई बातें मोदी जी करने लगे। हारता हुआ चुनाव देखकर लगता है अरे हमारा नेता तय है, हमारी बारात तय है, हम बारात लेके आएंगे, जैसे ही हमारा बहुमत साबित होगा तैयार रहें मोदी जी उस हमारे नेता को, जो उनको देखने में भी अच्छा लगेगा, काम करने में भी अच्छा लगेगा, प्रधानमंत्री के रूप में शपथ दिला देंगे बगल में बैठ के।
And after the Prime Minister said political circles are buzz with his remarks, BJP netas hinted at Rahul Gandhi as contender. Ajay Alok asks, is that person Rahul Gandhi?
नेता रूठ जा रहे हैं कि मुझे नेता डिक्लेयर करो तब मैं प्रचार करने जाऊंगा। अब देखिए कौन हो सकता है, शरद पवार तो हो नहीं सकते क्योंकि वो तो खुद सुप्रिया को जिताने के लिए परेशान है, स्टालिन हो नहीं सकते क्योंकि साउथ तक कन्फाइंड है, अरविंद केजरीवाल जेल में ही है, तो बचा कौन, अखिलेश की हालत वैसी पतली है, तो इस मामले में तो लगता है बचा एक ही आदमी, राहुल बाबा। नाराज हैं क्या? अरे पहले कांग्रेस पार्टी ही तो आपको नेता डिक्लेयर कर दे, वहाँ भी तो ये दिक्कत है। अब ऐसे भी नाराज फुफाओं की फौज तो घमंडियों में भरी हुई है।
So Ajay Alok is of the opinion that given that everybody is caught in their own individual challenges, rather they're facing with individual challenges, it could be Rahul Gandhi, it could just be Rahul Gandhi. Also as a message for Rahul Gandhi, if he's not happy, then he says, let your party at least announce you as the PM candidate. So that's a sly jibe coming in from Ajay Alok of the BJP. He's spoken of the situation that Sharad Pawar finds himself in, how he's fighting for his daughter, how Arvind Kejriwal continues to be in Tihar jail. Akhilesh Yadav's condition also something that Ajay Alok did remark on. But all of this began, most importantly, remember, with what the Prime Minister said. The Prime Minister said the last 15 days, there is a situation in the INDI bloc that one of the big leaders, the big faces of INDI bloc has refused to campaign till he or she is declared the prime ministerial candidate. Let me quickly take in a word from Clyde Crasto joining us on the phone line. Mr. Crasto, you know, it all began with the Prime Minister's remark. Very interesting, because he says, you know, after Nitish Kumar, perhaps there's someone else as well who's miffed, who wants to be declared the PM candidate.
Well, the Prime Minister, I mean, he has all the right to say what he's saying. It's going to be an SPD democracy. But the fact is, you know, the BJP is rattled by the India Alliance, because if they were not rattled, they would not be speaking so much everywhere, instead of talking to the people as to what they can do for the country, what is going to happen in the future for the country. They are constantly talking about the India Alliance. And they keep saying that we do not have a leader. Let me tell you something. We live in a democracy. After people elect the elected representatives, they will all come together and elect the leader. And as of now, the country is the leader. Every citizen who's going to vote is our leader. And these leaders will finally decide who their leader is going to be. So why is the BJP so rattled and worried, including the Prime Minister? I mean, he should just talk about the kind of work that he's doing, right? Instead of that, he's insisting on what the India Alliance is going to do.
No, but is it also not a matter of fact, Mr. Krasto, that the opposition for the longest time has struggled with reaching at one particular name for the Prime Minister's post, and hence they've decided to perhaps take the call post-elections?
The opposition toe the line of the people. Well, why should they do that? I mean, you know, they of people from the BJP, they have to worry about the country, right? Hmm. So when the elected representatives choose their people, they will finally decide who the leader is.
Okay, all right. Clyde Krasto, many thanks for speaking to us here on Times. Now let's quickly shift our attention to another reaction coming in from the RJD that contains a suo-motu pitch for who the mystery prime ministerial aspirant could be. Kanchana Yadav says if the prime minister means Lalu Prasad, then it's shameful because of RJD chief's health issues. Listen in.
Mr. Narendra Modi ji is on Bihar tour for the first phase of election campaign. And he is not able to speak on his both favorite subject, nepotism and corruption, because the NDA has given more tickets to the people coming from the family roots, and all the corrupts have been included in the NDA. Now they are part of the NDA. So now he is making another narrative, like this one is angry in India, that one is angry in India. Modi ji, don't go around and around. Answer the 10 questions that Tejaswi ji asked to you very directly. Why did you take electoral bonds after the ED and CBI actions? Why didn't you provide jobs to the 20 crore people in India in 10 years? Why are ED and CBI cases only against the opposition leaders? How many factories did you give to the Bihar in 10 years? Answer these questions. Don't create a false narrative. That's not going to work for you in Bihar.
All right, so those are the reactions coming in from several in the opposition. Many have come out to opine that this is the INDI bloc's personal decision, and the Prime Minister, the BJP for that matter, must not intervene. But here's something that the BJP has been asking since the very beginning of the coming together of the INDI bloc. Who's going to be the PM face of this bloc? Who's going to be the convener? And remember how Nitish Kumar stepped out of the alliance. He was apparently not satisfied at the manner in which seat-sharing talks were taking place, at the manner in which there was lack of decision-making when it came to who's going to be the face of the alliance and so on and so forth. And now what you see on your screens are some of the names of people who may just be seeking the top spot.